Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Western Armenia on the international agenda. The 600-year-old Armenian historical structures of Kharberd of Western Armenia are being robbed. World Heritage Mount Nemrut has no shortage of visitors. The Church of St. Minas of Erzrum, Western Armenia, became an object of vandalism. The ancient city of Gargamish, Ayntap, will turn into archeological reserve. Excavations have been started in Syunazard Caves of Marash, Western Armenia. A new documentary film about Artsakh is being shot. The presentation is scheduled for September 2. From June 28 to July 2, Prime Minister of Western Armenia Garnik Sarkisyan paid a working visit to Italy, where he had a number of meetings both with representatives of the political and economic circles of Italy and with representatives of other European countries. The main topic of the conversation was restoration of Western Armenia with regard to international law and its influence on interstate mutual interests. Prime Minister Sarkisyan briefed the interlocutors about the state structures of Western Armenia as well as its positive impact on the Middle East and on future international political and economic relations between states if the restoration of Western Armenia becomes a subject of international agreement. The proposals of Prime Minister Garnik Sarkisyan were received with great interest by all representatives of the meetings. They even enriched the conversation with additional points, especially when in the discussion program the mutual interests of all parties and the possibilities to solve current problems were clearly defined. During the meetings, a number of economic projects that are ready for launch were also discussed. Armenian historical buildings located in the Balin district of Kharberd, Western Armenia, are being robbed and destroyed, local media reported. According to the source, the 600-year-old historic site is in danger of being completely eliminated. During that period, there were supposedly two Armenian and one Muslim district churches and graves. For centuries, these historical structures, which have faced many natural disasters, have recently been destroyed by treasure hunters who are not satisfied with the destruction of history, but also by opening 600-year-old Armenian graves, trying to find precious metals as gold. The opened graves are not closed anymore and remain open. The locals ask to protect these historical buildings as soon as possible. Mount Nemrut, located in the Ayntap province of Samosat, included in the UNESCO World Heritage List, does not have shortage of local and foreign visitors. Being a part of the protected area of the national park, along with the unique sculptures, thanks to spectacular views of the sunrise and sunset, Mount Nemrut attracts many tourists from Western Armenia, as well as from Japan, Austria, Russia, China, and other countries of the world. Among the visitors, there are guests from the Republic of Armenia. The Church of St. Minas in the Azizia region of Erzurum in Western Armenia, built in 1719, became an object of vandalism. The Armenian owner of the church, who lives in Germany, does not allow to launch restoration works, and the builders outside the church carry out illegal excavations. Abandoned church today has become a gathering place for drug addicts and robbers. Local residents want the church to be restored or cleaned at least outside. Ancient Gargamish, which is considered to be the most important administrative center in the region for many centuries, and particularly Mesopotamia, will open an archaeological reserve for visitors. Head of the excavation works, Dr. Nicola Marcetti, said that tourists visiting the region can see the ruins of the palace and temple, the street with the Roman pillars, and the engravings of mythological creatures. The city served as the capital of a kingdom of the Hittite Empire. In the archaeological reserve, along with the excavation area, walkways, cafes, and resting places have been built for visitors. Excavations of 12 years in the Syunazard cave resumed. During the excavations were found remains of ancient animal bones. According to the specialist, it is possible to compare the DNA code of the remains with similar animals in the Middle East and Armenian highland. Last year, the remains of Caucasian deer were found here. These excavations can shed a light on the excavations in Karahoyuk, Temuraga, and Geche cave. The cave was used as a resting place from 40,000 to 9,000 BC on the road leading from the Mediterranean to the Armenian highlands. A new documentary film about Artsakh is being shot. The presentation is scheduled for September 2. Mystic Land Aran is being shot with the direct funding of Artur Jalalov, an Artsakh-born resident of Russia. Shootings of the movie have launched on 11 July in Stepanakert. In an interview with Artsakh Press, Levon Galastian, the author of the screenplay, mentioned that the film would try to get people closer to the secrets of Artsakh and how for centuries challenging foreign invaders, it managed to maintain its semi-independent existence. The author added that the scenario presents Artsakh's heroic episodes not only through the facts but also through the spiritual biography. Now let us represent to your attention a song Vartan Zoravar.
Հայրենյաց հոգի վարդան, արուշ վարդան, 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 հոգի սանք ույդ էր մի ղուրբան, էր մի ղուրբան.
You can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.